Hello, everybody. I am Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, here to talk dictators. They're all around us. You know they are, you know. I'm sure this guy behind me is Sacha Baron Cohen in disguise as the dictator, the Admiral General Aldeen. Aladdin, that's his name. He's just this crazy man with a fake beard. Our guy doesn't have a fake beard. He grew that one. Anyway, you know the story about Sacha Baron Cohen. You've all seen Borat, you've all seen Ali G, you've even seen Bruno, although you didn't like it that much. And this time, Sacha Baron Cohen is the dictator of the North African country of Wadia. Wadia, I think it's called. I don't know because I didn't pay attention to that part. Anyway, that horrible dictator, he has got to leave his country because he had this fabulous palace. And in that palace, he was able to boff any kind of movie star he wanted, including Megan Fox, who does an incredible job of acting, playing herself. In other words, if he gives her enough riches, she'll come in and have sex with the dictator. Also on the wall of Polaroids of people he's had sex with are Oprah Winfrey and Arnold Schwarzenegger. So you could see what kind of dictatorship this is. Anyway, he has to escape because his uncle, Ben Kingsley, wants to seize the throne. So he comes to New York and has to live in New York as a commoner. I mean, how horrible is that? Anyway, like most of these Sacha Baron Cohen films, except Borat, which I think is perfect, the laughs come, and then they go, and then they come back. But in this case, when they're here, when it's funny, it's really funny. I loved it when he came to a New York hotel, and John C. Reilly comes in as the manager, who's really a CIA agent. And he comes in, and he says to him, "You can't be in my hotel. I don't like Arabs in my hotel." And Sacha goes, "I'm not an Arab." And he says, "Well, you all look the same to me. Blacks, Jews, all those blue tree-hugging queers from Avatar." This is the kind of humor you get here, and I have a soft spot for it. I really like that. In fact, toward the end of this movie, and I really like the end of this movie, in the middle, it's him falling in love with a hairy, armpitted vegan played by Anna Faris with mousy brown hair. I could have done without any of that stuff. But I really like this end where he has to give a speech to UN dignitaries and people about the pleasures of a dictatorship and why a democracy is no good. And to see him get up there and start by saying, you know, in a dictatorship, the top 1% controls all the wealth and the 99% suffer. It's pretty familiar. It's the kind of laughs that stick in your throat. So I laughed at the dictator, and there were times I sat here like this. So dictator back there, whatever you are, you know, you have part of me and the other part just doesn't think you're funny. What can I say? But I'm grateful for what was funny. And I am not a dictator. I am Peter Travers, who only dictates your movie tastes for this one time a week.